Welcome to the WSI Priority Media YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be talking all about Google customer reviews, why they're important, and how that you can use them in your business. You know, people get confused all the time and they're always asking me the difference between Google reviews and Google seller ratings. They're two completely different things and they're used in two different scenarios. And I see people asking me, why are my Google reviews not showing up in my ad accounts? So we're going to walk through all of that, when to use what and how to be able to use them. But the fact of the matter is that reviews are a huge part of your business and they are a huge part of any business that wants to continue to grow and to succeed because people trust them. Look, 82% of consumers now say that they use reviews before making a buying decision. People are checking you out. Man, your information is out there everywhere, and people can find out everything they need to know in about 5 seconds by one visual observation of how many stars that you have. And it really makes a big difference. And so make sure that you're really using it. And so here's the areas where you can benefit from it. In your Google My Business, in your organic three packs, in the Google Maps, in the Google Ads, and the Google Shopping, all have really big advantages, and I'll show you each one of them. So when it comes down to Google My Business, if anybody searches by your business name, you should have this nice big, you know, Google My Business profile right here. All your reviews are being collected right here. Make sure that your Google My Business is properly optimized, that you have at least 10 images, that you have all of your business description, all of your business keywords that are set up in here, and that it is easily visible so that people can find it, and so the search engines can find it as well too. If you're not configured here, then you're not going to get the benefit from Google of being able to show up in some of the other valuable places like in the Google Maps. The Google Maps listing is a very important place for you to be showing up. So that's Google My Business listing. If you want to do some updating to that, you go to business.google.com. That's business.google.com. You log into your Google My Business profile and then you do all of the setup of that. So very, very important tool to use. The next section is the organic three pack. So we go into the organic three pack, and in this organic three pack right here, let me move my screen over just a little bit here. We have got obviously the local areas where the businesses are showing. All of your reviews are imported into there, and everybody pretty much knows the importance of that. But there is also the more places, the maps, where people really enjoy opening up that map and being able to look for you in there. And inside of the maps, again, a great place for you to be able to take advantage of additional business and additional business visibility. And in there, as you can see, you know, if you're running Google Ads, you're able to use those and be able to get to the top position. Let me give you an example, though, of Google Ads and where you can really shine with Google Ads is that you have the ability to jump right to the top. It's like the elevator right to the top by using Google Ads, and now you're at the very top. But in this case, it's Edward Park, right? He doesn't have quite as many reviews or as good reviews as this guy here, or this guy here who have them organically. He has the advantage of having the top position, which is really good. That's half the battle. However, if he were to use tools to be able to help him start getting more reviews and get up to the top, if he had 88 reviews and had the number one spot, our focus groups, after hundreds and hundreds of different variations of studying buyer behavior, show us this, that he would be increasing his conversions by 2 to 3%. 200 to 300% more people would actually choose him there at the top. So half the battle is being at the top, which Google Ads will help you do, and then the other half of the battle is in having more and better reviews than anybody else. So important. And then obviously your Google Ads are a big advantage all the way across the board, and then your Google Shopping as well too. So when we go to Google Ads, if you'll look at this right here, Wave Plastic Surgery, they've done that. Not only do they have more reviews than anybody else, but they've taken the elevator to the top. And so reviews plus Google Ads together, oh my gosh, Great strategy, great recipe for huge success. Now, if you're using the Google Shopping Network, that's a whole different story. This is where the Google seller ratings come in. If you can see right here, these reviews here, this is where I get asked often. It's like, hey, I'm running these Google seller ads, but there's no reviews that are showing up. I have all these great organic reviews. No, you need to have these reviews that are set up and that are linked with your ads account account. And here is what you want to do is if you want to test it, there is a testing tool that you can do. If you go to google.com/shopping/ratings/account/lookup ?Q=, and then put in your website address. I'll put this link down in the description box for you as well too, and just change this part right here, that last part, and put your website right in there. You can test to see, you know, what if you have a seller rating and where you are at as far as that's concerned. If you want to grow your seller ratings and you want your seller ratings to show up, then what you do is you go ahead and you get set up with Google Customer Reviews, and it's a completely free program. And what it does is it connects your site to post purchases, and Google automatically will aggregate those reviews for you, and they're collecting them, they're validating them, and so they're giving you that just beautiful exposure right here. And so now here's the what I call the perfect trifecta, right? This company's mattress firm, I don't represent them or not promoting them in any way, I'm just fallen in love with how well that they're following the guidelines that we teach our clients all the time, right? Google Shopping Network, using your Google Seller Reviews over here, using Google Ads, making sure that you've got a solid high-ranking position. Your Google reviews are showing up here, and then bam, look at that. They're in the three pack here, and then they're dominating the first spot, and then they've got their Google reviews showing up first. So they will be found, and they will convert at a very, very, very high level. So good for these guys, doing a great, great job, and that's what I recommend. So that's the difference between Google Local Reviews and Google Seller Reviews. You may need one, you may need the other, or you may need both, depends on your business. And so if you are a local business and you're looking to really enhance your Google reviews, you do that by two things. Number one is providing wonderful service. If you've got people that have got a head start on you and you need to catch up fast, I'm a big proponent of automation. I've seen it work over and over again, and I've seen companies that have been hundreds of reviews behind others, and by using automation, they've been able to catch up. Now, it's not faking reviews. You're not going to get anywhere by faking reviews. It's by using automation and texts and follow-ups that happen on autopilot to be able to remind your customers about leaving a review, and you'll just see the increase in tempo in reviews being left, and then you growing to have more reviews than anybody else in your industry. And so go to reputationadvantage.com. It is my favorite tool, and it is an outstanding just automation tool for growing your reviews. And if you are using the Google Seller Ratings, then what you want to do is you want to make sure that you are using Google's seller tool. And then number two is that you're linking your account with your Google Ads account. Very, very important that you create that link, because if you don't, then they're not going to populate in there. So you're focusing on Google customer reviews on whatever end of your business is. You may be needing the Google local reviews, seller ratings, or a combination of both, like in the mattress example. By you focusing on that, using it well, having it show every place, and continuing to develop your reputation, you will win. I hope that you have found this information to be helpful. And if you have, hey, leave me some comments, leave me some questions below. I respond to all my questions directly. And hey, why don't you go ahead and like it, comment, share, and also subscribe if you'd like to be alerted to any new videos that we've got coming out. And I've got a really cool bonus for you that I'd like to leave you with. And if you're looking to grow your business and really take it to the next level and say, hey, what are the best digital marketing steps that I can take in my business right now that'll help propel my business? Well, I've got something for you. We wrote the book. I mean, literally, we wrote the book. We have 12 of the very best authors, some best experts anywhere on the planet Earth, that have come together to each write a very specific chapter, because they're specialists in each one of those that will guide you through every part of the most important aspects of digital marketing. It is the number one book on digital marketing. You can get it on Amazon for $20, or my gift to you, if you're a subscriber of our channel, is you'll get it for free. So there's a link here someplace that you can follow. Grab a copy of the book, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you for being with us today. Until next time.